Okay, what's on the menu today?
Today we're going to make Soufiko, which is a well-known Ikarian dish and recognised as an Ikarian dish. And it's very tasty. It's made up of veggies, mainly eggplant and pepper, as much as you like, onion, garlic, and then you can add a bit of zucchini. I might not put it all in. And you can also add potato, which you would do if you had a big family. You add a bit more so that it is enough for everyone. But basically, it's eggplant, peppers, onion, garlic, and tomato. The onion and the garlic, sauté that a little bit. As much garlic as you like, it goes like this. It's a lovely meal. If you like to chop things up smaller, in smaller pieces, you could use it as a pizza topping very well. Really lovely, very tasty, and just great cheese on top, and you've got a nice pizza. So you just saute that a little bit. And basically you put everything in together. You don't add water, or if you do, just, you know, very small coffee cups. And the trick is to have it on a low heat so that it just cooks gently, and all the juices come out of the veggies, and it all just becomes one. They all the flavours combine really beautifully. And because, like, you know, years ago people didn't have big gardens, water was scarce. They had to water from the well with a bucket, and it was basically a few pepper plants, one or two maybe eggplants. So the veggies were few, and that's why they put all of them. I'd always put them in together to make up a big dish for the family. And they combine a lot of their veggies in their recipes. In the years where things were scarce, they put everything in the pan together to make a big meal for the big families that they normally had. And you can put the peppers in, which have just been cut up into slices like that.
Now, summer is drawing to a close, but you've got most of this has come out of the garden.
All of it is out of the garden except the onions and the garlic. Got peppers, zucchinis, eggplants, tomatoes now they're cutting. The beans are almost starting, they're still flowering. Of course, it's all from the garden. And people who love this recipe, when they go to Athens, they cook it. And they always say that it doesn't taste as good as it does in Ikaria.
So what's the story behind
the story Soufiko? Behind the name of this dish, Soufiko, one story is that because the meals were small, they weren't big and plentiful, and it had to go around, you know, for all the family, for every member of the family. The story is that the husband came home or saw that she was cooking the meal, and she said to her in the Ikarian dialect, tamufikis, meaning tamuafisis, will you leave some for me? Tamufikis. And she said, tasufiko, instead of, that's the Ikarian dialect. So from tasufiko, it came Soufiko. That's one story.
Smells nice.
Beautiful. I don't know. It's a combination of garlic, onion, pepper, and eggplant, and tomato. Now, you know, if you have the fresh tomatoes in, it's just beautiful. Here, I've chopped up quite a bit of eggplant, and I put it in water, and put a couple of spoons of coarse salt, and you can see that it releases the juice. It's sort of a black juice, which sort of gets the bitterness out of it. You know, some people do it, most people do it, and then you can just rinse it off. It's not salty at all, of course, but you can see the longer you leave it, the darker the water is, so that just makes it a bit more lighter, I suppose, on the system. And if you wanted to have it not as a main meal, you could cut it up dice it up in smaller pieces and cook it in the same way. I wouldn't put potatoes in. Zucchini if you wanted a couple of slices, but basically this is a tomato. It's a beautiful side dish. And as I said, you can use it on a pizza base, cook a pizza with it, and then it's, you know, diced up. And if you like, you could put just a teaspoon of sugar, depending on the amount of veggies, and a dribble of vinegar, and it's a sweet and sour Soufiko. No potatoes though. Mm. It's a beautiful as a side dish and accompaniment dish. Sweet and sour, it's just lovely. You can add the potatoes. And put in just a bit of zucchini. And I mix it first. And put tomato, if you've got fresh tomato, you know, good ripe one for cooking. It's even better, of course, you just chop them up or grate them. Got it on high heat, but once I've settled the veggies, I'll turn it down low. And because years ago, of course, they cooked on an open fire with wood, and people were so busy because they had so many jobs to do, you know, the woman would put the saucepan on the fire, and you know, keep an eye on it, make sure it was boiling steadily, and then she'd just go off. And the fire, of course, would dwindle, and it would get down to the coals, and the food would cook on the coals. So it just cooked very slowly, and she'd go off and do other jobs, of course. And that was the trick of it, I think, you know, cooking slowly. And, you know, all the juices just blend in very gradually. And ultimately the fire would die out and the food would be ready. Just a few zucchini pieces. And they release their juices. Yeah. Just dribbling a bit of water. Not a lot. So it's, you know, about this much water it was. Because the veggies will release their juices. You need to be careful always because this dish tends to catch a bit on the bottom of the pan.
And so far that's been simmering for about 40 minutes.
No, it's been simmering there. It could have been on a higher heat, but I was afraid it would catch on the bottom. So I kept it down low. Mm. But we'll turn it up now. It's on 1.5 and see how it goes. That's a Soufiko that's been... It took an hour to cook. For the last quarter of an hour, I raised it to 1.5. From 1/2 and raise the heat to make it bubble a bit, but you have to keep an eye on it because it catches on the bottom of the pan very easily.
As always, let's eat.